In this lesson, we're going to consider one of the things that probably I do the most out there in dealing with existing systems. Generally, all I do in my contracting business is perform repairs and maintenance to existing systems. So I get called in a lot when somebody has changed a bed, maybe they're changing the direction of their landscaping and are going to either put new plants in or are just trying to figure out maybe a better method of doing what they're doing. And that's the case here in this particular example. We're going to look at a bed running down the side of a driveway, and you're looking at the overview here of the property, and it's got 6 or 7 spray heads down the side of the driveway and the side of the house here, and it's just not doing a great job for the plants that our homeowner likes to put or has put and would like to add to in this bed. So we're looking at kind of how we'd lay out this drip zone here, but let's take a look at an actual picture of this bed, this side of the property here. We're going to be putting some drip line in there, and it has some existing sprays. So let's go back to another illustration here and kind of show what we're going to do. We're actually going to convert one of the spray heads over to a drip pressure reducing filter, and then we're going to eliminate the other 5 heads that are on this zone. So let's take a quick look at a video here that shows me replacing a spray head with Rainbird's Retro 1800, which is a drip pressure reducing filter that is made in the exact same size and form as their 1800 spray head. So this is designed to either fully replace, or you could take out the guts and just drop it into an existing 1800 spray body. But we're going to take the entire thing out because it's a different manufacturer's brand spray, and we're going to replace this. So, and we're going to take the spray head off of its half inch barb fitting here, make sure it's clean and all, and we're going to install our 1800 retro. And if you'll notice here, I generally don't use Teflon tape on fittings that go underground, but the fittings that are above ground, I will use them. So I want to hook up my drip line first so that as I'm putting dirt back into the hole and stabilizing our head here, I don't get any down in there. I mean, I like for the installation to be as clean as possible so that you don't get any dirt into your drip line right from the first day of operation. So, of course, you know, you're going to lay out the drip line, and we're going to staple it down once we get it get everything where we want it. But we're also going to want to cut all of the heads off that are on this zone so we're not having both the drip line and the sprays running. And most manufacturers make a cap that'll fit on their spray body head, and that's what we're using here. It's just a cap that has a little O-ring down inside of it, and you know, you can put it on the top there and it's sealed up. And I like to do this so that we're not losing the location of that spray, because a lot of times people change their mind about these drip zones or spray zones one way or another. So I like to leave the availability to come back and put that spray head back in. Who knows, they may put so many plants in here that you're going to need the drip and the sprays. That's happened to me before. People get really happy when they're planting plants and they're seeing that they're surviving. They may slam this bed full of plants that need a whole lot of water. So I always like to leave all of our existing options in place. But I want to show you a couple pictures here of a drip zone that I did in a commercial location, and their sprays just were not getting this hosta taken care of properly. So we've converted it over, same situation. It had a spray head there, and I put an 1800 retro in, and this is just 2 shots of this drip line going in. And also here's a shot of a tree. Now, you can do a lot of different things with trees. You can put the loops around them, or you could just, you know, wrap the drip line around it in a loop, or you could have a stripe coming down each side of the root ball or where it's going to be. But there are a couple of things to consider when you're laying this out, is the age of the plant, how large the root ball actually is, because if the plant was just planted, you're going to want to get that drip line as close to the trunk or that root ball as you possibly can. But within 2 or 3 years, the feeder roots, the small roots that are coming out that are actually taking the water in, they're going to be growing away from the plant. So you're going to need to space these drip lines out so that you can adequately water the edges of the root ball, not the interior of the root ball by the trunk, because that's where it needs the water the least. It actually needs the water further out so that it can encourage outward root growth, help stabilize the plant, and make it less dependent on your watering and more able to reach out into the surrounding soil and get water there.